What? What do you want me to do? I can begin?
Yes.
Okay. Om Jnanat Mirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksur Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine. Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Vancha Kaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanevyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're recounting the pastimes of a cowherd boy from Govardhan who was able to travel to the spiritual world and go to Goloka Vrindavan.
我们一直在讲述的是高尔德山的一个牧牛童，他的旅程，他旅行到了灵性世界，他去了灵性世界的格罗克文达文。So
we heard how one day Kaliya came to the Yamuna.
我们听到就有一天，卡利亚蛇来到了杨木河。And
Lord Krishna went there and he dived in the water of the Yamuna and Kaliya tied him and tangled him in his coils, and for some time Lord Krishna remained in the coils of Kaliya serpent. And then after some time, Lord Krishna then freed himself and then he danced on the hoods of Kaliya and he brought all the gopis onto the hoods of Kaliya and they were all dancing Rasa Lila on the hoods of the Kaliya snake. So Kaliya had with him the Nagapatnis, means the wives of the Kaliyas, and they were offering prayers to Lord Krishna. So Krishna took the shawl from the Kaliya, he took some of the shawls from the wives of the Kaliya serpent. And he used these shawls to make a rain, which went, he put it through the nose of Kaliya, and in this way he was controlling the Kaliya with these shawls, which were put through like rains through the nose of Kaliya serpent.
Krishna 就用这个披肩呢，就做成了一个缰绳，穿过了卡利亚蛇的鼻子，他就这样就用这个披肩做成的那个缰绳控制住了卡利亚蛇。So
Krishna was on the Kaliya serpent. He was riding on the Kaliya serpent just like you would ride a horse, and he was getting Kaliya to go forward. And in one hand he was holding his flute. In his right hand, he was holding the flute, and with the left hand, he's holding the reins, and he's making Kaliya go forward.
Krishna 驾驶就是卡利亚蛇呢就往前飞奔，而且 Krishna 呢右手还拿着笛子，他左手呢就控制就握住了这个缰绳，就骑在卡利亚蛇身上让他往前跑。
Sometimes Krishna would use his flute like it was a whip, and he would this way get Kaliya to go forward.
有的时候 Krishna 还把他的笛子当成了一个鞭子，就抽打着卡利亚蛇呢往前跑。
So actually, this was a great benediction for Kaliya, because to have Krishna ride on him like a horse is actually a very special thing.
蛇是有好处的，就卡利亚蛇呢，现在就变成了 Krishna 的坐骑。
Just like Garuda is the carrier of Lord Vishnu. He's very special. It's a great honor to be the carrier of the Lord. So for Kaliya to be the carrier of Lord Krishna is very special.
就像 Garuda 是主 Vishnu 的坐骑。这对于他来说是一个特殊的荣幸，所以卡利亚蛇呢现在成为了主 Krishna 的坐骑，也是非常荣幸的。
Yeah, when Krishna punishes wicked people, he takes away all their contamination.
当主 Krishna 惩罚邪恶之人的时候，就把他们所有的污染也都拿走了。
So the Nagapatnis.The wives of Kaliya, they said, we know our husband's very sinful, that's why he's got the body of a big snake. So your anger towards him was actually mercy.And then the wives of Kaliya, they came and they made offerings to Krishna. They brought cloth and flower garlands and different ornaments, valuable ornaments, and they gave them all to Krishna. And Krishna put them all on the hoods of Kaliya.
衣物、布匹、花环，还有饰物，这些珍贵的物品献给了主 Krishna， 然后主 Krishna 呢就把它们全都放在了卡利亚蛇的蛇头上。
And they had brought also different lotus flowers from the Yamuna. So Lord Krishna, he decorated himself and the gopis with the lotus flowers.
卡利亚蛇的妻子们还拿了一些莲花，从杨木那河的莲花做成的花环，然后主 Krishna 就用这些花环装饰了他自己和 Gopi 们。
And with the different ornaments he put on Kaliya, he also used them to decorate the Gopis.
还用这些装饰，卡利亚蛇的饰物来装饰 Gopi 牧牛姑娘们。
First he put them on Kaliya's hoods, and then, while the gopis were all standing on the hoods, he decorated the gopis and himself with them.
首先主 Krishna 呢是用这些物品呢装饰了卡利亚蛇的头棚，然后他又拿起这些饰物装饰了他自己，还有装饰了 Gopi 们牛姑娘。
And Kaliya is glorifying Krishna, offering prayers to Krishna. He has many mouths, and with all of his mouths, he's glorifying Krishna.
Kaliya 蛇呢就用他许许多多的口开始荣耀主 Krishna.
So there's a blessing from Krishna that Kaliya was becoming like Anantashesha, just like Anantashesha offers prayers to the Lord.With all of his mouths. So Kaliya was doing the same.
This is a blessing.
So then Krishna came out from the lake, and all the friends and the family, they were all so happy, they were all dancing in ecstasy. Krishna brought all the young gopis, they were all with him on the hoods of Kaliya. Krishna brought them all down from the hoods of Kaliya. So this way Kaliya was filled with happiness because he got so much mercy from Krishna. He got mercy which even Garuda doesn't get. Because Krishna with his lotus feet had been standing on the heads of Kaliya. So Krishna gave a benediction to Kaliya that his heads would always, his hoods would always be marked with the lotus footprints of Lord Krishna. So Krishna is so amazing that he gives such kindness to such a sinful person as Kaliya. So when Krishna came out from the Yamuna, Nanda Maharaj was so joyful, he was shedding so much tears. He was worshipping Krishna and embracing Krishna again and again. So then Krishna gave some instructions to Kaliya serpent, and he told him, he said, you should not remain here any longer. You don't stay here in the Yamuna any longer. Go back to the ocean. This Yamuna River is for the cows and for the humans, not for you snakes. So you take all your family and wives and children and relatives, you all go. And then Krishna gave a benediction. He said, if anybody remembers my instructions to you to go to leave Vrindavan and go to the ocean, he said, then if they hear this pastime at sunrise and sunset, then they will never be afraid of you. So all the cowherd men and women, they had a festival, singing and playing, making music, and they were so happy, they were so joyful. And Krishna was very satisfied, and everybody came back to the village. Then another time, two great demons, Kesi demon and Arista demon, came to Vrindavan.
有两个恶魔 Kishimo 和 Aristamo 来到了 Vrindavan。
These two demons, they were very favorite servants of sinful Kamsa.
这两个 罪恶的恶魔是 Kamsa 的最喜爱的仆人。
So the first of the demons, Kesi, he has the form of a huge horse. And Arista, he's like a bull. So they terrified all the people everywhere in Gokula. Together, one time they entered the village and their bodies were touching the sky and they made so much sound, everyone was terrified. So the pastime about Krishna defeating Kaliya, that's the ratha about Krishna as a hero and also about sadness or something which is called pathos. It means sad or pity. But the next pastime is about pure devotion, about heroism, just about being a great hero.
Krishna 打败卡利亚蛇的这段逍遥时光呢，他就展示了Krishna 的英勇，以及一种称为 patho， 就是悲伤的一种情怀。而下一段逍遥时光呢，这显示的是 Krishna 的英勇以及纯粹的奉爱。
So these two demons, they came to Gokula and they gave so much, they terrified all the people in the village and all the cows also. They had these huge bodies and they were just trampling everything and everyone with their heavy feet. So Krishna's devotees, the gopis and Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda, they tried to stop Krishna. They didn't want him to go near these two demons who were so huge.
Krishna 的奉献者们，那些牧牛姑娘，还有南大大君亚修的妈妈，都试图阻止 Krishna 接近这两个恶魔。
But Krishna could not be persuaded. Krishna was determined. He had to go there and deal with them. Krishna's got a lot of courage. He's not afraid of anyone.
但是 Krishna 是无法被劝阻的。他心已决，他要去对付那两个恶魔。他有巨大的勇气，他什么也不怕。
But the people of Vrindavan, they think of Krishna as a child, as a boy, and they want to protect him and they're concerned for his safety. They tell him, don't go near them, stay away.
可是 Vrindavan Gokula 的人们都把 Krishna 看成一个小男孩，他们担心他的安全，他们就想保护他。所以他们就告诉他，你不要走近，离远点。
So this Kesi demon in the form of a horse, he came running before Krishna. He was running very fast, but Krishna just kicked him and tossed him away.
这只恶马就急速地朝 Krishna 飞奔过来，然而 Krishna 一脚就把他给踢得 踢到老远的地方。
So then Krishna got Aristasura. Aristasura is in the form of a bull. So Krishna made a hole in his nose and he tied him up and he brought him before Lord Shiva, Gopeshwara.
接着就 Krishna 又开始对付 Aristasura 这只公牛魔，他就在他的鼻子上穿了一个洞，就把他制服了，就把他带到了主 Shiva Gopeshwar 面前。
So Casey, because Casey is in the form of a horse, he moved very fast, so he came first to Krishna. So Krishna just kicked him far away, so far away that it would be hard for him to come back.
Krishna 是一只马的样子，他行走的速度非常快，所以就 Krishna 呢就第一个就对付了这只马魔，就一脚把他踢到遥远的地方。
And then Krishna got this Arista, who is in the form of a bull, and he tied him up and he brought him to Lord Shiva. There's a Gopeshwara deity, which is a Shiva Linga in Vrindavan, and he brought him there and he made him sit there, tied up.
然后就 Krishna 呢又把这个公牛魔 Aristasura 把它捆了起来，就在 Vrindavan 呢有 Gopeshwara 这个神像，也就是主的 Shiva Linga 的神像，然后主 Krishna 就把它捆了起来，让它坐在了这个神像面前。
Lord Shiva has a bull also. He travels usually on the bull Nandi. And so it was appropriate. Lord Krishna thought, let him also have Arista. He can also be carrier for Lord Shiva.
Krishna 有自己的主 Shiva, 他也有一头公牛，是 Nandi, 是他的坐骑。Krishna 就想，让这个 Aristasura 也成为主 Shiva 的坐骑吧。
So Krishna kept him tied up so that he couldn't give any more trouble.
Krishna 就把他捆了起来，让他不要再捣乱。
But then Kesi returned, the horse demon who Krishna had kicked away, he returned and he jumped up and when Kesi returned, Krishna jumped on him. And Krishna was jumped on the back of Kesi demon and he was training him how to, he was making him be his horse.
就在这个时候呢，被 Krishna 一脚踢跑了的 Kesi 魔又跑了回来，然后主 Krishna 就纵身一跃跳到了 Kesi 魔的身上，就开始训练他，把他训练他成为自己的坐骑。
Yeah, you know, to train the horse in the beginning, they're very wild and they jump, they try to throw you. But Krishna was on the back of Kesi and Krishna didn't get off. He kept Kesi going, he made Kesi become tame.
我们都知道要训马的过程，就是当一匹野马他被人训练的时候呢，他会上蹿下跳的把这个他背上的人扔下去，但是主 Krishna 就稳稳地坐在他的身上，没有从他的背上下来，就把他给驯服了。
And then Krishna brought many of his friends and he got them also to ride on the back of Kesi and they got the horse to jump around and to do different tricks and give fun to the people on the back.
然后主 Krishna 还让他的朋友们也一起也坐在了这个马魔身上，让这个马跳来跳去的，并且就像耍把式一样，就让人是给人们带来开心，让人们感到很滑稽。
Yeah, Krishna and all of his friends, they were enjoying on the back of Kesi. Sometimes Kesi demon would be up in the air, sometimes on the ground, and this way they were enjoying.The ride, pleasure ride.
Krishna 和他的朋友呢，特别享受，就是坐在这个马身上。这个马呢，一会儿它跳到空中呢，一会儿又在地上跑， 所以他们就非常高兴的就骑在这个马身上。
So Krishna kept the horse demon tied up with ropes, and he kept it in the village, in the cowher village, so that the people in the village, whenever they wanted any fun to enjoy, they could use the horse. They could get on the back and go for a ride.
Krishna 呢就用绳子，拴住了这匹马，就把它让它在待在这个村子里头。就什么时候村子里的人呢想要骑马取乐的时候呢，他们就会骑在这个马的身上，就骑马兜圈或者开心。
And he kept the Aristasura bull, he kept him, he thought he can pull the carts when we need to pull some carts and we can use the Arista bull.
之后呢又Krishna 又让这 Aristasura 呢这个马公牛又去拉车，让他什么时候呢有需要拉车的时候呢，就让这个 Aristasura 干这个拉车的。
So the next pastime describes how Akrura came to get Krishna. Krishna was living in the home of Nanda Maharaj, Nandishwara, in the town Nandishwara, the home of Nanda Maharaj, and Akrura came there to bring Krishna to Mathura to meet Kamsa.
下一个小时光呢是关于 Akura 前来把 Krishna 带走的小时光。Krishna 住在 Nanda 大将的家中， Akura 呢就来要把 Krishna 带到 Mathura。
So this pastime is also about Karuna Ras. Karuna Ras means the pastime of pure mercy.
This 个消时光呢是有关于 Karuna Ras, 纯粹的仁慈的消时光。
So in the Nanda Maharaj's home is called Nandeshwara. There's a hill there, and on top of the hill is the palace of Nanda Maharaj, where he lives with all of his family. So that's both in Goloka and in Gokula.
Nanda 大君的家呢，叫做 Nandeshwara， 是坐落在山顶。他和他的家人呢，就居住在山顶的这个宫殿里。
We were hearing pastimes about Krishna in the forest. But this pastime now, Krishna is at home in Nandagram, the home of Nanda Maharaj. So these pastimes which happened in Braja, they're if even stones and logs and other lifeless objects, if they hear what happened, when they hear what happened in Vrindavan, they'll feel so sad that they will all shatter to pieces.
那么在 Braja, 连那些石头、木头和没有生物的物体听了这个 Vrindavan 的这个消失光呢，他们也会内心异常的悲痛，他们都会因为悲伤而变成了碎片。
We already heard about the trees and the rocks in Vrindavan, how they're very conscious and they're very attached to Krishna.
我们之前已经听到了，Vrindavan 的树木、石头，他们都是有知觉的，他们深深的都依附 Krishna。
So we're going to hear about how Krishna Akrura has come to take Krishna away from Vrindavan, and this will break the hearts of even objects which are not in Vrindavan, which are outside Krishna's abode.
接下来的这位Akura带走Krishna的消失光呢，就会令甚至没有居住在文达文的文达文之外的居民们也伤心欲绝。
So when the people of Gokula, when they heard that Akura had come there, they all cried and they were fainting again and again. They would collapse, faltering. They were so worried that, oh, Akura has come, it's going to take Krishna away from us.
阿里波。Sorry，Akura的人们呢？当他们听说Akura来了以后，他们都痛哭不已，他们反复的晕倒，晕了过去，然后他们都瘫倒在地上，他们满心的担心和焦虑，Krishna，Akura要把Krishna带走。
They all knew who Akura was, and they all knew why he had come.
他们都知道Akura是谁，以及他此行的目的。So Yashoda
was terrified of Kamsa, and she wanted to hide Krishna.
Yashoda呢特别害怕Kamsa，他就想把Krishna给藏起来。
And when she heard that Akura had come, she covered Krishna with her cloth. And she was chanting mantras for his protection. But she knew it was going to be very difficult to hide Krishna. So when Nanda Maharaj woke up the next morning, Akrura came to him and he explained everything to him and told him everything which is supposed to happen.
第二天清晨，当南达大君来的时候，Akura呢就向他给南达大君解释了。
Akrura reminded Nanda Maharaj about how sinful and how cruel Kamsa was.
Nanda 大君就提醒 Akrura, Kamsa 是多么的罪恶，多么残忍的一个人。
But Akrura also reminded Nanda Maharaj that Krishna was able to deal with this evil, with this sinful king. So Nanda Maharaj had no choice, he had to let Krishna go because he knew there were so many people in Mathura, they needed Krishna to come there to save them from Kamsa.
没有什么选择，他只能让 Krishna 走，因为他知道 Mathura 有那么多的人，他们还等着 Krishna 前去把他们营救出来。
So the gopis, they were also very much in anxiety, and they knew what was happening, and they were watching Nanda Maharaj, and they thought Nanda Maharaj is killing us, he's taking away our life.
都陷入了巨大的焦虑当中，他们知道这些发生的事情，他们都死死地盯着南达马哈拉着看，心里想，南达要杀了我们，他们就要他要把我们的生命拿走。So,
the gopis were crying out, "Oh, alas! Oh no! Oh, don't send Krishna away, please."
然后，勾皮们他们都开始哭嚎起来。 请不要让 Krishna 离开。
So Nanda Maharaj, he escorted Krishna out of the house, to brought him to Akrura, and the gopis were watching. There was nothing they could do. They were just looking and staring.
Nanda 大君呢就陪着 Krishna 就走出了家门，把他交给了 Akrura。那些 gopi 们呢，他们就这样呆呆的就注视着。他们心内心感到非常恐惧。
Then Yashoda came, Mother Yashoda came outside, and she's crying. So many tears are coming from her eyes, and she took Krishna's hand, and she take Krishna's hand, she put it in the hand of Akrura.
Yashoda 妈妈呢，也从家里走了出来，她哭得跟泪人一样。他就拿起了 Krishna 的手，放在了，交给了 Akrura。
Just like she was asking Akrura that I'm giving my son to you, you take care of him.
亚修达对 Akrura 说：“我把我的儿子交给你照顾了，请你好好的照顾他。”
Just like if we have some property and we give it to someone to take care of it for us.Then it's their responsibility to take care of it.
就好像我们有一些财产，我们就交托给另外一个人照料，那么这就是另外一个人的责任了。
So if you give property to someone to take care of it, and then they don't give it back to you, they cheat you, then it's very sinful, and the government should punish people who do that.
那倘若你把你的财产交给另外一个人托管给他，可是另外一个人呢反而不还给你了，那么这就是一个欺骗，这是罪恶，应当受到政府的惩罚。
But then Mother Yashoda turns to Nanda Maharaj, her husband, and she says to him, I place our son in your hand, so this boy isMore dear to me than life or any money. So don't trust anyone. Just bring him back here. Bring him back home when you finish the business.
接着亚修达又转头转向了他的丈夫南达，对他说道，我们的儿子现在在你的手上了，这个孩子他比生命还比财富对我更加珍贵，请你把他带回家，带回到我身边。
So Mother Yashoda was telling her husband, "Don't trust so much Akrura. It's your responsibility to bring back Krishna to Vrindavan. Don't just leave everything for Akrura to do."
亚修达就叮嘱她的丈夫，不要相信了 Akrura， 这是你的责任。你让 Krishna 回到本他们，这是你的责任。
So Mother Yashoda was feeling so much separation from Krishna. She fainted again and again. And then finally she returned and she went inside to her home, which was very lonely because there was no Krishna anymore.
亚修达因为和 Krishna 的分离呢，她一再的就晕厥了过去，最终他走进了自己的家，但是这时候他的家已经没有 Krishna， 他感到异常的孤独。
So all the women of Vrindavan began to lament because they saw Krishna's about to leave, so they had no hope anymore.
所有的女人们，她们都内心感到巨大的悲痛，她们看到这 Krishna 即将离开。
Just remembering about that scene, Krishna leaving Vrindavan, it's so sad, it makes even stones cry, and the trees also shed tears.
请记住这一幕， Krishna 离开 Vrindavan 的这个令人悲伤的场面，甚至连石头也哭泣，是 甚至连树木也流下了泪水。
So just remembering that, it's so painful. And so a devotee, they want to give up their life when they hear about it.
请记住这个小时光，这是非常令人伤心欲绝的。当奉献者听到这个小时光的时候，他们想要放弃自己的生命。
So Mother Yashoda was trying to pacify the minds of all the other ladies there in Vrindavan, and she would try to speak things to try to comfort them in the pain.
Yashoda 现在试图安慰所有那些伤心的妇女，她对她们讲话，想安抚她们悲痛的心。
But whatever Mother Yashoda would say, the women would just answer something. They would be angry. They would be angry with her. They were not happy.
但是无论她说什么，那些妇女们，那些她们都非常的对她生气、愤怒，她们内心都不快乐。
Mother Yashoda was trying to tell them, you know, it's okay. I've given Krishna to my husband Nanda Maharaj and to Akrura, and they will take care, then they'll bring him back.
Yashoda, 跟他们说，没有关系了，我已经把我的 Krishna 交给了我的丈夫 Nanda Maharaj, 交给了 Akrura, 他们会好好的照顾他，会把他带回来。
So Mother Yashoda was so simple-hearted, she didn't doubt them. She didn't doubt that Krishna will come back, that they will bring Krishna back.
Yashoda, she is a very simple person. She thought they would bring Krishna back.
But at the same time, she knew that Akrura sometimes he doesn't always do what he says. Sometimes he will do something else.
但是与此同时，野兽的也知道 ，Akura 他有的时候是说话不算数的。他说了一件事，但是他去做另一件事。
So the ladies in Vrindavan, they said to Mother Yashoda, they said, you're cruel. He said, you don't have any sense. You're like somebody. You're like a cow who has a calf, and they put their calf into the care of a tiger.
这些女士们就对雅舍德说，你太残忍了，你也没有头脑，你就像一只母牛，把自己的牛犊竟然交给一头老虎。
Your home is empty now, it can be burned down. How can you even go in there alone?
你的家现在已经空荡荡了，它甚至都可以被烧掉。你怎么能够一个人进入这个空荡荡的家呢？
But you gave your son to Kamsa's servant. You know, Kamsa is so sinful. So what can you expect any good to happen?
你把你的儿子竟然交给了康瑟的仆人。康瑟是这么罪恶的人，你难道你还期望会有什么好事发生吗？
So this way the ladies of Mathura, they were chastising Yashoda and they were cursing Akrura for taking Krishna away.
就这样，就这些女人们，她们就斥责Yashoda，诅咒Akrura把Krishna带走。
So when they saw Krishna leaving, they rushed, came out, they came running out and they ran after him and they were calling out to him and crying.
他们就这样眼睁睁地看着 Krishna 即将离开，他们就在后面追赶、呼唤、哭泣。
And all the ladies, the gopis, they were chastising Nanda Maharaj also, and they were chastising all the other men. They said, "Why didn't you stop him? Why didn't you stop him from taking Krishna away?"
这些女人们又开始斥责男的和村子里的其他男人们，斥责他们，你们为什么不阻止阿库拉，为什么允许他把克什纳带走呢？
So this crying which the ladies of Vrindavan was doing because it was so painful, it caused everyone else began to cry as well.
这些女人们她们的哭声是这么的悲伤，这使得别的人也跟着一起哭了起来。
Akrura, Nanda Maharaj, Balaram, and the cowherd men, and even Krishna, they were all crying.
Akrura, Nanda Maharaj, Balaram, 还有其他的男性，甚至 Krishna 也都跟着哭了起来。
And Krishna was all getting onto Akrura's chariot at this time. He's getting ready to go. So they were thinking, oh no, Krishna's going to leave us. So then he looked and he saw the gopis. He saw that the gopis said they were almost going to die, they're ready to give up their life. So Krishna got down from the chariot and he came to speak to them.
Krishna, 他看了一眼那些勾皮母牛姑娘，她们几乎已经快死了，她们几乎就要放弃自己的生命，所以 Krishna 就从车上下来。
So Krishna, he led the gopis away. They went into a forest grove where they could talk privately.
Krishna 就把这些 gopi 们就带到了森林里，他好在私下里跟他们悄悄地说话。
But then Akrura came and he saw that, hey, Krishna's not on the chariot.And he understood, oh no, what's happened, you know. He thought, I can't go there, I can't go to Mathura without Krishna. So what's happened to Krishna?
这时候Akrura过来了，他一看Krishna不在车上，他就心想，发生了什么事情？我可不能一个人去Mathura。
So he tried to get, first of all, get Balaram on his side, to get Balaram's confidence. And he told Balaram, he was telling him about Vasudeva and Devaki and the Yadavas, how they're suffering so much, and the only one who can save them.Who can help them is Krishna.
Also, Balaram, 有关于 Vasudeva 和 Devaki 的悲惨的处境，以及那些亚度的族人，他们是多么的悲伤。唯一能拯救他们脱离这种处境的是 Krishna.
Yeah, actually, Krishna is the cause of all their suffering.
实际上 ，Krishna 是他们受苦的根源。
And so Balaram, of course, he's the son of Rohini and Vasudev. So he went to search for Krishna.
Balaram is Rohini and Vasudev's son. He went to search Krishna.
And they were able to find the place in the forest where Krishna had gone with the gopis. So Balaram, he's also the son of Vasudev, like Krishna, the son of Vasudev. So Akrura, he got Balaram to help him to find him.Krishna.
Balaram 呢，跟 Krishna 一样，也是 Vasudeva 的儿子。Akrura 呢，就让 Balarama 帮他去找 Krishna。
And he did it by telling them about Vasudev, how his father Vasudev, Balaram's father Vasudev, is suffering so much. And Krishna, by going to Mathura, he can save Vasudev from so much suffering.
Akura 呢就告诉Balarama, 他的父亲 Vasudev, 他现在在受着苦。如果 Krishna 去 Mathura, 就可以把 Vasudev 从痛苦当中拯救出来。
So then they found Krishna's footprints, and they followed them, and they found the place where Krishna and the gopis had gone.
Krishna 就寻着沿着 Krishna, Balarama 就沿着 Krishna 留在地上的足印，就找到了他和 gopis 们在一起的地方。
So when Balaram saw Krishna surrounded by the gopis, Balaram, he didn't say anything, he just stood away, kept a distance away. But Akrura, he spoke out.
当 Balarama 看见 Krishna 四周围绕着那些 gopi 们的时候呢，他没有说话，他远远地站在一边，但是 Akrura 大声地说话。
He made sure that Lord Krishna would hear what he was saying. So Akrura said, he said, evil Kamsa, that sinful Kamsa is causing your old parents so much suffering, giving them so much trouble.
Akrura 就高声地说道，那个邪恶的、罪恶的 Kamsa, 他让你年迈的父母亲在受着苦，给他们带来了麻烦。
He's ready to kill them if you don't go there.
如果你不去那里的话，康瑟就准备杀掉他们。
So it's your duty not to neglect. They're your devotees, so you have to go there and save them from all their fear and all their suffering.
这是你的职责，保护你的奉献者，去拯救他们，营救他们。他内心充满了恐惧，他内心是充满了痛苦。
They're actually Devaki and Vasudev were in the prison, and they were terrified that Kamsa may come and kill them.
Devaki 和 Vasudev 他们就深陷在大牢当中，他们。很担心康瑟时刻就会来杀死他们。
And Akrura tells them, if we waste time, if we don't go quickly, they're in so much suffering, with so much difficulty, that they may just die anyway on their own without Kamsa killing them.
Akrura 说，如果我们不应该浪费时间，应该尽快的前去，因为他们是这么的痛苦，他们有这么多困难，甚至是不等到康瑟来杀死他们自己就可能随时死去。
You're the Lord, Akrura is telling Krishna, you're the only shelter for the Yadavas.
Akrura 就对 Krishna 说，你是亚度族人唯一的庇护所。
They're all living in terror of Kamsa, and so also do the demigods and the brahmanas and other very exalted persons. They're all suffering because of Kamsa, so you have to help them. You have to give them some hope.
在马图勒，还有那些半神人们、婆罗门，还有别的人，他们这些受苦的人，他们都被吓，都感到内心很害怕，他们都在受苦，受康瑟的恐，康瑟在恐吓着他们，只有你才能帮助他们，只给他们带来希望。
So Akrura is telling Krishna that.Vasudeva and Devaki are not the only ones suffering.
就这样阿库拉告诉 Krishna， 阿斯蒂瓦和 Devaki 不只是他们两个人在受苦。
All the Yadavas are also suffering.
所有那些亚杜族人们也在受苦。
So Lord Krishna is the only one who can give them any hope, who can deliver them from their situation.
主 Krishna 是救他们脱离这种苦海的唯一的希望。
And if Akrura comes back to Mathura without Krishna, then they will have no hope.
如果没有 Krishna, Akrura 孤身一人回到 Mathura 的话，那么这些人他们就没有指望了。
The princes of the Yadu dynasty, they're all depending on Krishna, and the demigods are also depending on Krishna.
Yadu 王朝的王子们，他们唯一的依靠是 Krishna， 而那些半神人们，他们也唯一依靠 Krishna。
Demigods like Indra and Brahmanas like Garga Acharya and all the cows and all the devotees, their only hope is Lord Krishna.
天帝 Indra 还有 Garga Acharya 母牛还有奉献者们，他们唯一的希望是主 Krishna。
And the Kamsa is so proud, he's always boasting about how strong he is. Nobody can defeat him.
Kamsa is 非常骄傲自负的，他总是吹嘘自己的力量，声称没人能打败他。
And Kamsa he has people worship him. Many demons, they all worship Kamsa.So in the beginning, you see, Akrura was trying to change Krishna's mind, and he was encouraging Krishna to feel sorry for the people in Mathura.
就这样，一开始 ，Akrura 呢试图说服 Krishna 来改变他的心意，让他为 Mathura 的人们的处境感到难过、悲伤。
But he didn't get much reaction, didn't get much response from Krishna. So now he wants to make Krishna angry. He's going to tell Krishna about all the sinful things Kamsa's doing. So Akrura is speaking about the different demon friends of Kamsa and how they help Kamsa to make him more proud.
Akrura 就一一提起了 Kamsa 的那些恶魔朋友们，他们的言谈举止就使得 Kamsa 就更加骄傲。
And other demons from different kingdoms outside Mathura.They're also supporting Kamsa, and they're trying to defeat the devotees and the demigods.
还有马图勒城之外的其他的那些邪恶的国王们，他们也纷纷支持康瑟来打败奉献者，打败半神人。
So Akrura, after saying this.Then he took some grass between his teeth and he cried. He cried again and again.
说完这番话， Akura 就拾起了一片草，地上的草衔在自己的口中，就开始哭泣了起来。
So Akrura had this very difficult task to do, to take Krishna away from Vrindavan, to bring him to Mathura. So he offered his obeisances to all the women of Vrindavan, one by one.
Akura 呢就有这个身负着这个艰巨的要把 Krishna 从 Vrindavan 带走的重任，所以他挨个的逐一的向 Vrindavan 的每一位女士们顶拜。
So Akura, he was trying to convince Krishna to come with him to Mathura, but Krishna was controlled by his devotees, the gopis. They had so much love for him, Krishna didn't want to leave them.
Akura 试图说服 Krishna 跟他一起离开，但是 Krishna 受到了 gopi 们那个强烈的爱的控制，所以他不想离开 gopi 们。
So he was trying to get the mercy of the gopis. He was approaching all the gopis and asking them, please understand the need for Krishna to go there. Akrura's name means somebody is not cruel. But for the women of Mathura, they said this is the most cruel thing you could do to take Krishna away from us.
Akura 这个字面的意思是不残忍，但是 Akura 要把 Krishna 带走，所以那些 gopi 们他认为 Akura 是最残忍的人。
Okay, so we will stop here. All right, are there any questions?
Yes.
Okay, what questions have you got? Highlighting the good qualities of a woman.
不是，不是打压和不尊重，它只是彰显了女人的优秀品质。
Draupadi became glorious by those men insulting her, that she tolerated their insult and she took shelter of Lord Krishna.And Lord Krishna saved her.
Draupadi 就是在这个受到侮辱的事件，在这个事件当中，她受到侮辱，然后她容忍了他们，并且托庇于 Krishna， 得到 Krishna 的拯救。因为这个事件 ，Draupadi 就受到了荣耀。
So Draupadi is known as one of the most chaste, the greatest.Chaste women in the world, in history. She's famous for her chastity.
Draupadi, 她地位非常伟大。
Of course, the men who insulted her, they're the most sinful, they're the most degraded, the most disgusting of men.
当然，那些侮辱遮帕帝的那些男子们，他们那些人呢？他们是罪恶深重的，而且是最下流的、最无耻的人。
So Lord Krishna encouraged Draupadi to be tolerant and to accept these things. So he encouraged Draupadi to show, even though it was a difficult situation, but if you show good qualities, it's a proper behavior.
So Krishna 鼓励了 Draupadi.让他要容忍，要接受这个处境和接受这个艰难，彰显他的优秀品质，这是他的正确做法。
Okay.
The next part of the question is, 薄伽梵歌在当今社会还有保护女性的意义吗？怎么才能理解这个知识？是超超越时间空间的呢？Is there any significance for Bhagavad Gita in the modern society in the regard of woman protection? So how to understand this knowledge is transcend time and space? Thank you.
This knowledge transcends time and space because it's eternal truth. It doesn't depend, it's not relative truth, it's absolute truth. Absolute truth is beyond time and space.
This knowledge is eternal truth, because it's not relative truth, it's absolute truth. It's absolute truth, it's beyond time and space.
So you're worried about women protection. The whole purpose of the Vedic culture is to protect women.
那么您担心是对妇女保护感到担心，整个的伟大文化它就强调了要保护妇女。
The problem today in Kali Yuga, a lot of the problems today come about because of independent women.
这个卡利年代很多问题的出现是由于独立的妇女导致的。
Women should be protected. When they're young, the father protects them. When they're married, their husband protects them. And in old age, their son should protect them.
女的应该受到保护，她们年轻的时候受到父亲保护。他们长大之后受到丈夫的保护，他们老了之后受到儿子的保护。
So, you want protection? That's very good. You should go to your husband. Your husband will protect you.
你需要得到保护，这是非常好的。应该去找你的丈夫，你的丈夫会保护您的。
But if you go out to work all day and you work with a lot of men, materialistic men, you're not going to get protection. They will exploit you.
但是如果你在整天在外面上班，然后工作都和一些男子在一起工作，和一些物质主义者的男子们，他们可不会保护您。
They will exploit.
他们会剥削你。
Yeah.They'll take advantage. Women are taken advantage of today in this materialistic society. They go out to work. We say men and women are equal, but the woman has to get pregnant. She has to give birth to the child. How are they equal?
This materialistic society emphasizes gender equality.但是只有妇女才可以怀孕生孩子，在这一方面那哪有平等可言呢？
So this is how men take advantage of women. The woman, the poor woman, has to go out to work at the same time she gets pregnant. She has to give birth to children. She has to somehow take care of the child at the same time she has to work. Okay, 下一个问题。 Okay, my humble obeisances to Panchatattva Prabhu. Gopeshwara. Gopeshwara is a special name of Lord Shiva, given to him in Vrindavan, because Lord Shiva wanted to take part in the rasa dance.
Yeah.
So Lord Shiva wanted to join the Rasa Leela. So he was told you have to bathe in this kund. So Lord Shiva took bath in the kund and he came out as a gopi. And then he went to Rasa Leela. But Lord Krishna told him, he said, you know, Rasa Leela is not for you. Rasa Leela is for the Vrindavan gopis, not for you. So he told Lord Shiva, he said, you stay here in Vrindavan, as you can be the controller, the leader of the gopis, Gopeshwara. It means the one who is the leader of the gopis. And it's a Shiva Linga. It's a form of Lord Shiva there in Vrindavan. Yeah, it's a Shiva Linga, but sometimes they will dress the Shiva Linga as a gopi. They'll put a sari around the Shiva Linga to show that Lord Shiva becomes a gopi. Well, you have to understand that time is only a moment of time in the spiritual world. The time which he spent in the material world, you know, one, the whole lifetime of Brahma is only one breath of Mahavishnu. So although it seems like a long time, you know, you're hearing about so many things, he went so many places and everything, but it's a very short time in terms of eternal time. Anyway, Sanatana Goswami is telling us, this pastime about Gopkumar, about his travels and how he went back to the spiritual world.
不管怎么说，Sanatana Goswami他就记述了
Gopakumar 的这个旅行，他是怎样回到灵性世界的旅行。He wants us, Sanatana Goswami wants us to know about all the different regions which are there, both in the material universe and in the spiritual world.
Sanatana Goswami 想要让人们知道不同的在物质世界以及灵性世界的不同的区域。
If we did not have this book, Brihad Bhagavatamrita, we wouldn't know about all of these places.
Okay,
下一个问题.
下一个问题是来自于Shruti Rupa. Krishna， 有新人在坚持聆听薄伽梵歌后提问 ，Krishna 智觉应该是一门非常完善系统的灵性科学。请问，一个成年人应该具备什么条件，才能被推荐前往印度这样的 Krishna 智觉大学系统学习呢 ？Hare Krishna， some devotee， listening。 Baba Gita for some times, and after that, these new people raised the question that since Krishna consciousness is a systematic, perfect spiritual science, so what's the prerequisite? What's the condition for adult for this kind of people to go to the place like India, who is university for Krishna consciousness, for him to go to India to learn systematically?
Well, it's not required that you have to go to India to learn systematically. You can learn in your own home.
是这样，你不需要。 就是去印度，得到系统的学习，你就在家就可以学习。Yes.
Sometimes people may go to India, but it's not required. You can learn everything. You have the book, and you read the book, and you can be guided by senior devotees. We use modern technology to give lectures and to guide people to study.
你就可以，你可以就是待在家中，就读书，然后有年长的奉献者们，他们讲课可以指导你，然后你可以利用当代的技术来聆听讲课，可以提问。
We're giving more and more classes online, and sometimes also devotees are not free during the week. So we're having special arrangements to give classes on the weekends. So they study more on the weekend. They do not have classes during the week, they just study on the weekend. But in this way they're able to study and to go through all the courses.
我们有很多在，我们现在有越来越多的在线课程，如果没有，就是平常没有时间的话，在周末就有很多的课程。 然后在周末呢，就可以系统的来学习这些课程了。
Okay.
The next one.
Yeah.
这个是 Ra. 问题：女人只能嫁一次，那男性老婆没了可以再娶吗？ The question is that the woman can only have one marriage, but if the man loses his wife, can this man marry another woman?
Yes, they can. if the first wife somehow, if she died unexpectedly, or somehow the marriage was not successful, then they may remarry.
如果他们的妻子死了，或就是意外的突然死去，或者是他们的婚姻不成功，他们可以再婚。
Of course, this may happen again and again. Someone else may think that, well, this is my karma, that Krishna doesn't want me to be married. Krishna's ended my marriage, so maybe I should just devote myself to practice celibacy.
但是有的人他们会转念一想，这是我的 karma， 我的业报，可能 Krishna 不想让我有婚姻，那我就终生的把余生用来遵守。
The main point is that if you're going to marry, you have to be able to take care of your wife. You have to be able to provide for her. You have to give her proper home, and you have to give her proper facility.
主要的要点就是，在婚姻当中的男性应该照料丈夫，要照料妻子，给妻子呢提供一个家，提供恰当的生活设施。You're
going to have a wife, it means you have to protect her. You have to take care of her. It means you have to provide what she needs to keep her safe.
你有接受一位妻子，就意味着你有责任保护妻子、照顾妻子，并且满足妻子的需求，并让她有安全感。Okay. 下一个问题，如何从相处的人身上看到 Krishna 呢？举例，周日听课，那个马大姐因为不想要二胎难受，她不想取悦她的丈夫。 可是如果说主想要第二个孩子，他是能接受的，他可以娶 Krishna， 但是让他娶 Krishna， 但让他娶丈夫，他并不特别乐意。这两种想法矛盾吗？娶丈夫和娶 Krishna 矛盾吗？Let's continue with the last question.
Okay.
So how the next part is how to see Krishna from the person that we are dealing with. For example, on Sunday during the lecture, we heard that Mataji don't want to have a second child. She doesn't want to please her husband. But if the Lord But it is said that if the Lord wants the second child, she can accept that to please Krishna, but she's not willing to please her husband. So is there any contradiction between those two ideas, to please the husband and to please Krishna? Is there any contradiction?
Well, the duty of a chaste wife is to please her husband.
一位贞洁妻子的责任就是要取悦自己的丈夫。
Of course, the husband wants a child, it should be according to religious principles.
当然了，如果丈夫想要孩子的话，就必须得。
Most women are not so advanced that they just simply want to please Krishna. Their duty is to please their husband, They're married. They accepted married life. They accepted a husband. They have a responsibility. Just as the husband has a responsibility to protect the wife has a responsibility to please the husband. You have to understand the spiritual world is, while it appears like the material world, there are some differences. So, there can be the impression of air, just to have the feeling like the air, but it's not that the soul is depending on air. Try to first of all understand you're not the body, then you can try to understand. After you've fully understood you're not the body, then you can think more about the spiritual world.
Panchadevabha said, thank you for your mercy, dear Maharaj.
Well, thank him for his mercy also.
Okay, that's all.
No more questions?
There's no more question on this chat.
Okay. So we'll finish here?
Now there's more question coming up. One more.
Okay.
下一个，这是现在又出来一个问题是 ，I see 林迈姑罗和所有奉献者 Bhagavad-gita 1.1 对他 Vastra 的询问是在战争开打前，还是在 Bhishma 倒下第10天呢？ 感恩姑罗。 The obeisance to Guru and all devotees. The inquiry from Dhritarashtra in chapter 1, text 1 of Bhagavad Gita, is this happened before the battle? So, or after 10 days after the battle, after Grandfather Bhishma has fallen down,
before the battle.
这个询问是在战争开打之前的。
They're having a live transmission. Sanjay has got mystic power by the grace of Vyasadev, and he's able to see everything taking place at Kurukshetra.
Sanjay, he got Vyasadev 的仁慈，他就有这个玄秘的神通，可以看到这个看到战场上发生的情景。
So, as it happens, it's all being described to Dhritarashtra.
So he 就把战场上的情景一幕一幕的讲给 Dhritarashtra 王听。
So his inquiry was put before the battle.
因此就在战争开打之前，他提出这个问题。
Yeah.
So the next one is from Chen Chen. 我们念诵的 Hare Krishna mantra 里的 Rama 是不是就是主 Ramachandra 这个化身呢？
Yes. Well, when we chant the Maha mantra, Rama can be Ramachandra, but it can also be Balarama.
当我们念诵 Maha mantra 的时候。Rama, 它既可以指 Ramachandra, 也可以指 Balarama.
One time, two devotees were arguing. One devotee was saying, in the Maha Mantra, Rama means Lord Ramachandra. But another devotee was arguing, saying, no, it's Lord Balarama.
有一次，有两位奉献者发生争执。有一位奉献者说，这个 Maha Mantra 当中的 Rama 是指的 Ramachandra， 另一位奉献者说，不是的，这个 Rama 是指的 Balarama。
So they went to Prabhupada, and Prabhupada said, the one devotee said to Prabhupada, isn't it when we chant Hari Rama in the Maha Mantra that this Rama is Ramachandra? And Prabhupada said, yes, you're right.
然后两个奉献者就找到了 Prabhupada， 其中一个奉献者就向 Prabhupada 问：我们唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra 的时候，我们唱诵 Hare Rama 的时候，这个 Rama 是不是指的是 Ramachandra？ Prabhupada 回答说：是的，你说的是对的。
So then the other devotee said, but Prabhupada, isn't it when we chant Hare Rama, Hare Rama, this Rama is Balarama? And Prabhupada said, yes, you're right.
这时候另一位奉献者又对帕帕德开始问道，帕帕德，当我们念 Hari Rama Hari Rama 的时候，这个 Rama 是不是 Balarama 呢？帕帕德说，是的，你说的是对的，正确的。
He said, Prabhupada said, you're both right. This Rama can be Ramachandra, it can be also Balarama.
帕帕德说，你们俩说的都是正确的，这个 Rama它既可以是指的 Ramachandra， 也可以指 Balarama。
And if you read Jiva Goswami, one of the six Goswamis, Jiva Goswami, he explains that when we chant Hari Rama, Hari Rama, Rama Rama, Hari Hari, that this Rama is actually Lord Krishna.
六 Goswami 当中的 Jiva Goswami 解释说。当我们念诵 Hari Rama Hari Rama Rama Hari Hari 的时候，这个 Rama 也可以是指的，这个 Rama 指的是 Krishna。
Because it's Lord Krishna who is the reservoir of all pleasure for all souls, so he is also Lord Krishna is also Rama。
正是主 Krishna， 他是所有灵魂的快乐的泉源。所以这个 Rama 也可以是指的 Krishna。
So you can worship, and you can think of Krishna, or you can think of Rama, or you can think of Ramachandra, Balarama, as you like.
When Nilvati ask, what is duality? How to transcend duality? What's the help for our spiritual practice and life if we transcend duality?
Yes. Well, duality means things like happiness and distress, heat and cold, success, failure.
二元性就是比如说苦、乐、冷、热、成功、失败。
So the tendency of human nature is that we rejoice when we get good results and we lament when we have a bad result.
人类的本性呢，就是当我们得到了好的结果呢，就会欣喜；当我们得到了坏的结果呢，就会悲伤。
So we hear from Lord Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes that heat and cold is like happiness and distress. And Lord Krishna says the winter and summer seasons are there for everyone. We have to tolerate them and we have to learn not to be disturbed by them.
主Krishna在《薄伽梵歌》当中就说到，冷、热和苦乐，就好像冬夏季节的交替。每个人他们都要，他们感受到这些二元性，但是他们应当容忍，不受打扰。So
to transcend the duality, we have to understand that if we don't transcend the duality, we become very much affected by the different results. And we rejoice when we get something good and we greatly lament when something is not right. So it's better to be equipoised and to keep the mind steady.
我们不超越二元性的话，就会受到这个结果的影响。当我们得到了想要的，就会开心；然后得不到呢，就会伤感悲叹。我们应当保持平衡、平和，还保持稳定。Lord
Krishna encourages us not to be attached to the results, and not to be so much affected by the results. We should understand we are not the doer, we are just the instrument in the service of Krishna.
主Krishna就教导我们要不依附结果，要不要受到结果的影响。我们并不是作为者，我们只是在服务，我们在服务当中只是一个工具和手段而已。
So, it's a good training for the mind to learn to become tolerant of different conditions, not to rejoice and not to lament, but to be equipoised, to be steady.
对心意而言呢，要学会在容忍不同境况，这是对心意来说是一个良好的训练。不要欣喜，不要悲伤，要保持心境的平和、平衡和稳定。Actually,
the happiness and the distress is simply in the mind. So it's simply an adjustment of the mind. That in the mind we're thinking this is very good. And so, to somebody else, they may think, well, it's not so good. And somebody else, and sometimes we're suffering, and somebody else thinks, oh, not a big problem. And so it's how our mind views these different situations. The mind can be the friend, the mind can be the enemy. We have to learn how to control the mind. So we're thinking this is good. One minute we're thinking this is very good, another minute we're thinking this is very bad. The same situation, it's just the mind perceives it in a different way. Okay. Yes.
So Chen, she raised the question. She paid obeisance to you, and she expressed her gratitude to your explanation. Mm-hmm. The next question is from Hari Vamsa. Nanda Maharaj 是普通人, Nanda Maharaj 是 一般人,常人,怎么可能进入到Varuna的水中宫殿,不需要氧气呢? Nanda Maharaj is an ordinary human being. How can he enter into the palace of Varuna, which is below the surface, is under the water, and do not need to breathe oxygen?
Well, Nanda Maharaj is not an ordinary person. Nanda Maharaj is a Nija Siddha. He's from the spiritual world.
Nanda Maharaj 不是普通人,他是 Nitya Siddha, 他是来自灵性世界的。
So please don't think Nanda Maharaj is an ordinary person.
请不要把Nanda Maharaj当成普通人。But
If the servant of Varuna wants to arrest someone, they can make arrangements to take him to the kingdom of, to the palace of Varuna, to the place of Varuna. We don't know how they arrange it, but somehow they arrange that they can live there. Just like if you go underwater, usually you go underwater, you'll come up, but it's arranged somehow. There's special arrangement, special facility wherever Varuna is, wherever his palace is, that when they take people there, there's an arrangement for them to live beyond our mind and senses to understand.
他们可以做出安排居住在那里就像我们有的时候潜入水下然后又从水中上来所以他们就可以做出安排提供一些设施让他能够去那瓦鲁纳的宫殿所以这些都是超越了我们的心意和感官的理解范畴之外的
There are many things beyond our own mind and senses. We don't know a lot of things. There's many things we do not know.
There are many things 我们的心意和感官都不知道，有很多事情都超越了我们的心意和感官的范畴之外的，我们根本就不理解不了解。
So you have to hear, you have to hear from the scriptures. And the more we hear, the more we'll learn and understand.
所以需要聆听，需要聆听经典。嗯，我们聆听的越多经典，我们就可以学习到更多，并且更多的理解这些事物。
嗯哼。
No more question.
Okay. So 今天我们讲到这儿。我们感谢 Guru Mani 给我们正太的翻译，感谢所有的奉献者聆听，祝福你们唱诵快乐。
Thank you, Maharaj.
Thank you, Guru Mani. Go ahead.
昆之君服务员听，我们非常感谢，马老师给我们带来精彩讲课，感谢所有奉献者的耐心聆听和提出的这些问题，祝大家在 Krishna 直觉当中度过美好的一天 ，Hare Krishna。
Srila Prabhupada ki，
在。
Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki，
在。
Hare Krishna。